for me today. Started coming in Sundays because all the benches are empty when it comes to chess. Because everybody's so used to their comfort zone and coming in Mondays to do chess. So, I switch it up on them. I come in on Sundays. Every day is training day, yo. Superset training. Weapons of mass destruction. Killing calories. All black today. I'm all black because I'm in a funeral and I'm killing calories in this fat. Fat killer. Beast mode training. 125 pound on the flat. 115 on the incline. Dumbbells. Reverse grip on the 205 on the barbell. 50 pound flies. 125 pound lat pulls. Push-ups. That's one round. Comfort zone killer. No gimmicks, y'all. 115s. Incline. 125. Flat. Legit, yo. 50 pound flies, yo. All steel.
Outrun the fastest lion. Or the slowest gazelle. I thought I might add that to my presentation. Like, you ain't necessarily got to beat the lion. You just beat them other gazelles. No, you missed it in the background. High school dropout, homeless, didn't meet my father until I was 30 years old. But I wake up every morning at 3 o'clock. Why? Because you just got to get there before the genius get there. You just got to get there before the magnum cum laude and the summa cum laude get there. They ain't waking up to 8. So if you get up at 3, you ain't got to be smarter than them. You just got to be quicker than them. You just got to be faster than them. You just got to get to the spot before they get to the spot. You ain't got to be them. You ain't got to be on their level. You don't have to be as smart. You don't have to become them. You can stay you, but you got to get there before they get there if you're going to stay you. And so the gazelle, like, I gotta go. And the lion knows that if it is to survive, it must catch the slowest gazelle or the weakest gazelle. Now, this is deep, y'all. This is deep. Please, if you don't get anything else I'm saying, you have to get this concept of going all in. You have to get this beast mode. You gotta get this beast. I wanna show you. Let me show you. You gotta get this beast mode. You gotta embody beast mode. Everything about you has to say, I ain't playing. If it's to have, I'm gonna get it. And I ain't leaving none of it behind. It's mine. Beast mode. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. And so the gazelle is running and the lion is chasing it. And the story says, it doesn't make a difference if you're a gazelle or a lion. When the sun come up, you better stop running. Now watch this, this is what's deep. Although the lion is the king of the jungle and can devour a gazelle, the gazelle ain't like, yup, I can't beat my man, so let me just go in. So let me lay down and let my man eat me. If the lion is gonna eat with his bad self, it still gotta grind. And what y'all getting confused is y'all don't think they grind. Y'all think they got here chilling. Or y'all think they used to grind and when they got here, they stopped grinding. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. I was grinding already. And then when I saw that Tony Robbins was only 3 speakers ahead of me. You thought I was grinding at first. When I saw my man in the distance, I said I was a high school dropout. I was homeless. How I catch Tony? Tony, you better run. And you better run fast. Because your boy, E.T., I'm coming to get it. I'm coming to get it. I'm coming to get it. And your problem is... What up, what up, what up, what up? It's your boy, E.T., and welcome to another edition of, that's right, a Rio Special Olympic edition of Bring It From The Bottom, baby. Thank God it's Monday. All right, you knew I was going here. Come on, we couldn't do the Olympics without, yep, Michael Phelps. That's right, baby. Over 20-something medals, right? Come on, come on. Over 20-something also gold medals. Come on. All right. Why are we talking about Michael Phelps? Because we're talking about not just competing. Like I told you before, not just competing, guys, but dominance, right? We talking about dominance. We talking about this kid has been doing it since he was young, right? Three times. And my man came back for the third time, right? And dominated. So we talking about a dynasty, right? We talking about a dynasty. There's some of you out there, you're like, E, I want to be successful. Look, I'm not talking about baby success. We talking about a dynasty. How do I guarantee that we keep doing this generation after generation after generation? I'm telling you, the way you do it, number one, Michael Phelps style, is you kill the noise. Are you hearing what I'm telling you? You got to kill the noise. And many of you cannot get to your level of success. You cannot get to dominance. You cannot get to dynasty because you are worried about everything that's coming in your ear, guys. You got all kind of distractions from the left, from the right, from in front of you, from behind, on the side of you. Like, you are constantly bombarded with noise, and you've got to learn how to be mature enough to silence the noise. Did you see Michael Phelps? Let's go back. You saw my man. Yep. You saw my man. Like, he was trying to intimidate Michael Phelps. And my man, all in his space, he's trying to strike fear. He's trying to distract him. And look at the face. Come on. Look at Michael Phelps' face. Look at his disposition. It is total focus. It is the eye of the tiger. And I'm telling you, in the midst of everything you go through, I've been fired from some jobs. Come on. Eye of the tiger, I stayed focused. I've been talked about by some people. Eye of the tiger, focus. I've gone through my own personal trials and tribulations. Eye of the tiger, focus. You gotta learn to kill the noise. Who cares what they say? Dominance. Who cares what they think? Dominance. Listen to me, nothing succeeds like success. You wanna kill your haters? You wanna shut them down? You wanna kill the noise? Nothing succeeds like success. And Michael Phelps was focused on one thing and one thing only, the gold medal. All right, guys, before we get out of here, I got to give you number two. All right, listen to me. I said there's levels to this. Come on, CJ said you got to master the levels, right? But Mason said you have to dominate your lane. Michael Phelps dominated the lane. Watch it. Watch it from the beginning. Boom. He comes off. Boom. The dive in the water. It's strong. Look at the strokes. Look at the strokes. Look at the strokes. Look at the strokes. Boom. Watch the turn. Underwater. Watch the turn. Boom. He comes off of that wall strong. Watch it as he gets closer and closer. They close. But watch as he pulls away at the end. Why? He's dominating his lane. You got to get in your lane and dominate your lane. Listen to me. I'm not the only motivational speaker in the world. Oh, come on. You got Les Brown, right? Killing the game for years. You got Tony Robbins murdering the game for years. Are you hearing me? But Eric Thomas, I stay in my lane. I don't try to be like Les Brown. I don't try to be like Tony Robbins. I stay in my lane. I dominate my space. And I'm telling you, if you can learn to kill the noise and dominate your space, your lane, stay in your lane and dominate your lane, I'm telling you, not only will you compete, not only will you dominate, but you, my friend, will leave a dynasty. It's your boy E.T. saying, I dare you to dominate. I challenge you to find your space, stay in your space, and create something in your space that has never been created before. Control your lane. I dare you to believe in yourself so much so that you don't need the affirmations of others. I dare you to believe in your uniqueness. I dare you to believe in you. I dare you to stand up for yourself. I dare you to dominate your space, your world, and to leave a legacy. It's your boy E.T. saying, silence the noise, my friend, and you can have, be, and you